What? Tell me more about like your physical transformation, because I'm always someone who's unhappy with the way I look, even though I make a meme out of it. I'm not like utterly depressed, but I know I'd be happier if I was more fit.
Yeah. You're like me in a way that I at least what I could imagine is like, you know, after I just literally put up on my Insta story a picture of your belly, looking down at the camera with your belly there.
Oh, great.
like, it's like, you know, right. You post it yourself as well. I remember I have these times where I'll sit down, like, to put on socks, and I'll be like, look at this bad boy, you know?
There's a lot of people who can relate to that right now.
Yeah, and whoever's around, I'm like, come give this a pinch. They're like, I don't want to touch it. I'm like, come touch it. They're like, it's fine. It's not even that bad. You're like,
you're lying to me. Did this ever happen to you? This was one of my, I was fatter than I am now, my most fat, and I was like, I got to do something about this. I went to tie my shoe, and I couldn't breathe. That was my lowest point. Did that ever happen to you?
Well, I don't know if I can't breathe, but like,
I couldn't breathe.
I go to put on the socks, and it would be like, when I'm done, I'd be like,
right.
Like, come on, like, oh, there's like a air trap in there. Yeah.
I had to hold my breath. I would literally take a deep breath.
That's insane. Well,
I know.
At your age?
For me, I had a moment where I was just looking in the mirror, and I just had like an angle before I was getting in the shower, probably charging a phone at the same time and whatever, and I just looked back, and I was like, is that my ass or my back?
No, no.
Or where does my back end, my right. ass begin? I'm like, right. what's happening? And I was like, just like, that's my body. I was like, it's like fully, like people joke, like potato, but like I was full on potato ass.
Huh.
And that was just a moment for me. I was like, oh, I should maybe change a bit.
Mm.
All I did was drop the carbs. I did the no carb thing.
Keto?
Yeah, the keto diet. Okay. It was good. That's it. I enjoyed it.
Are you still on the keto?
No, I got off it. I think it's not meant to be forever type thing, but Amir, one of the guys that cooks on Epic Mealtime, has been on it like nonstop, and he's just gone from like disgusting slob to really trim guy.
Mm. I have seen those before and after pictures.
Yeah, they're wild, and it's just it was literally just for me a big thing was drinking water. Because if you drink water, then you stop snacking.
Mm-hmm.
And, if you're watching and you're a disgusting slob, and I'm a disgusting slob, but I transition back and forth between the two, I would say drink, and it always sounds cliche and dumb, and you're like, oh, you idiot, drink more water. Seriously, I started drinking. If you aim to drink like 6 to 8 liters of water a day, don't even get me started on Coke Zero and Diet Coke. I love that shit, but it makes
but
you
how
want.
Bad is
it makes
bad.
You. It's like it's even without bad. Breaking it down, it makes you want to eat more.
Yeah,
it makes you want to.
The
snack.
Fake sugar doesn't work.
No.
Well, this is what I heard. Apparently, we have triggers to sweetness. And remember, everything I'm saying is nonsense. Who the fuck am I? I'm not anyone that ever should be commenting on that stuff. But quote me on this, that when you have something sweet, like Diet Coke is super sweet, Coke Zero is super sweet, there are receptors in our body where it's like sweet means high calorie. It's a treat. Mm-hmm. So it's like, oh, incoming, intense sweetness, crank up the metabolism. Let's go, boys. Lots of sugar coming through. Oh, no sugar? Mm-hmm. That's weird. I thought there was going to be lots of sugar.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess we're wrong. And then it creates these false alarms. Mm-hmm. So the next time when you are eating something sweet or something that does have a lot of carbs in it, your body's like, ah, he's just joking. It's Diet Coke.
Doesn't metabolize it. Right.
And then you just get destroyed. And
That's right.
Yeah, I feel like
I think
that.
That's true.
I feel like that's got to be right.
The biggest thing, though, for me was sleep. Because I hate sleeping. I love staying up late. I'm always you don't need to sleep. That's so stupid. Like, you're better off, you know, trying to stay awake as hard as you can.
You don't enjoy sleeping?
I love sleeping when it happens.
But trying to sleep.
But now these days, it's like once midnight rolls around, I'm like, oh, now no one's going to fuck with my shit. I can start that video game I wanted to start, or I can go on, I can work on something that's like a side thing, or I could, sit there just smoking, watching like 5 hours of a cult on Netflix, whatever it is. I just value that solo time I get there at night.
So how did you make that switch? You're saying you used to do that and now you sleep.
Well, now I've been traveling, so I go back and forth all over the time. I've had terrible sleep the last couple of days, but I noticed that at my best, it's like a domino effect. It starts with water and then sleep.
Mm.
And then I want to go to the gym. And then you just don't want to snack at that point.
Because you're already committed.
Yeah, you don't want to do anything else.
So when you went from potato in the mirror.
Yep.
I don't know why. I just had to pause.
I'm on my way back to potato in the mirror.
You look good. You're not a potato in the mirror right now.
Yeah, I can show you something.
You're not a potato in the mirror of my eye. your beautiful chiseled Jewish warrior. We were talking about how you're a Jewish warrior before, but
we said that you look like a warrior.
I was saying there's two types of Jews in the world. There's like little like hey, like me, and then there's like Jewish warriors like during the King of David, like biblical shit. But anyway, when you went from potato in the mirror
to Jewish
warrior,
was it
like a straight like you were like I'm in, I'm going.
Yeah, it's if you really think about all the times I looked at myself and I was like, oh, terrible. Like all those times culminate in many false starts.
Right.
There's so many times where it's like, now it's the time.
See, that's my
and then something happens. You're like, wait, tomorrow might be the time because that's good. Exactly. Yeah. But those false starts are important. They really are. I really feel like you build on that. Like,
interesting.
Like I maybe got to a place where I felt comfortable because I had all those false starts leading up to it.
Mm-hmm.
That wouldn't have happened if I didn't feel one way, you know, many times, you know, because after the fifth time, you're gonna be like, am I going to say this is going down again or am I going to lie to myself again? Right. How many times?
Right.
For me, it was like 27 times. Keep
doing
that's
it. That's cool. I like
keep doing
that.
It. Keep failing. Seriously.
I like that. No, I think that's important for people listening to remember that it's okay to have those false starts because eventually you're going to get to the point you want to be at.
Yeah, definitely.